Okay, so first of all, welcome Sandeep again, for giving us some time to address our cohort and talk about networking, right? So hope and this, so guys, this has been the third session in a series of lectures that Sandeep is taking, which is around the networking, and we have got thanks a lot for your very good feedback also on the session. Right, so we have organized this session so that you guys can start your career either in cybersecurity or in networking, right? So for any of these two, we need to have a very, very good basics on networking, and that's the reason why we have had Sandeep as as an instructor for this workshop. So Sandeep is a practicing network engineer. He's right now working with the Buhler, which is a German MNC. He has got almost 12 years of work experience, and his experience spans along many companies. Before Buhler, he was in Infosys, and before that also he has been part of multiple companies. He has seen the evolution of networking domain, right? So right now also very he has interest spanning across networking as cloud networking, as well as other domain, software defined networking. So but even before we go into further detail, we thought of having a much better base understanding of the networking itself, and that's why we asked Sandeep to have this class as a very, very basic person for people who are just starting their career. So welcome again, Sandeep. So before we start the session, probably I'll just take 2-3 more minutes to explain about Antroc, right? Since you guys are here, so Antroc is an edtech platform, right? Which not only conducts the master classes like this, but we also have our full bootcamp also. So that's actually a premium services. So we have multiple bootcamps. One of our bootcamps are in cybersecurity. Other one is data engineering. We have two more boot camps which are coming up in DevOps and maybe front-end engineering very soon, right? And the boot camp that we have launched on cybersecurity, that's a placement guaranteed boot camp where there are two models where either you can there's income sharing agreement also, so that's why how we keep the cost low on this boot camp, right? And we provide you the placement assistance so that by the end of this course you are able to get a job. And the cybersecurity course, a full length course of 15 or 16 weeks, where different experts like Sandeep, they come and they teach right, and different aspects. And that course itself is heavily focused upon the SOC, right? And on the other hand, we have a lot of tie-ups also with many companies for placement. Our batch on placement has kind of done. The two has just started undergoing since they have just completed their SOC portion. Right, so please check it out. I'll share a link about our course also here. Do check it out. Somebody from our team will reach out to you. Other than that, guys, please enjoy this session. Ask a lot of questions from Sandeep. He will be very happy to answer all the questions. The most important part for the session round right now is that you go away with the session with a very, very defined learning outcome, right? And so Sandeep, over to you. Please welcome again. Thanks a lot for spending your time to help us out.
Yeah, thanks Ram. Thanks Gaish for joining. So I think most of you were present in previous class where we discussed about routing's fundamental. So Ram, am I audible correctly, or is there any volume low, high, or something?
No, you are perfectly audible, Sandeep.
Perfect. Thanks. So I have just enabled chat. So I think anyone of you guys want to ask any question, you can just put over the chat and then I can respond to you during the session. Yeah. All right. So let's move on. Let me just quickly bring my screen and then we can start. All right, so let me know if you can see my screen and then I'll start. Guys, yes, no, over the chat. Can you see my screen?
Yes, Sandeep, actually, I can see. Guys, please use your chat windows for all your questions. Sandeep will be taking up that one. And please respond also. You know, a lot of times, Sandeep, still people are asking questions. Please respond on chat. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, yeah, thanks. All right, so just to recap from the previous class, we were on routing. We were discussing some stuff of routing, and then we left a few portions over that. So routing, as you know, that it's like reach to different subnet from one subnet. So if I have a router and it's connected one PC which belongs to, let's say, 10.10.10.0/24 subnet, and in this router one more guy is connected and its IP is 192.168.1.0/24, let's say some IP, random IP he has, 1.34, doesn't matter. So reaching from this PC, let's say PC1 to PC2, okay, and communicating between two different network, you need always a L3 device. And that L3 device, which will route your traffic to the different subnet traffic, and then you can have reachability via that. So L3, in my case, I have router here, but even it can be a firewall, it can be a router or any other L3 device. All routers, whether it's Cisco, Juniper, or anyone else, it's all more or less, they have only the one job: forward your traffic to different subnet. So if you connect any one more subnet here, which are, let's say, 172.16.8.0/24, and you want to reach again, you send your traffic to router will forward this traffic to this subnet. So the job of router is routing the packet as per its routing table. Okay. I'm just starting this very quickly because most of the portion we covered in last class, but it's just a recap. So your router job is to forward your packet from one network to other network. Okay. And it's just look at your destination. It will not look from where this packet is coming. I mean, it will not look at source. So if PC1 is sending the packet to PC2, your router will not aware whether it's PC1 or PC2 who is sending the packet. It will only look at destination, check the routing table, and forward the packet to the destination. Okay. We discussed some rules when you connect any device to router. Both directly connected devices should be into the same subnet. So if it is, your PC is having IP 10.10.10.11, this interface, which is directly connected to PC1, must have 10.10.10. And any free IP. In my case, I'll give one. And this will act as a gateway for PC1. Now, how the communication happens, the complete flow, the routing flow, we discussed in previous class. You can go through the video and that would be more clear to you guys. Okay. Now, as soon as you configure this interface with this IP and same manner, this interface with 192.168.1.1, I'll give to this interface of the router, and this interface again 172.168.8.1, I'll give IP to this interface of the router, it will create automatically a routing table in it. Okay, and the routing table looks like that. C means connected. Which network is connected to me? 10.10.10.0 172.16.8.0 192.168.1.0. So it will immediately note down whatever the directly connected network it has on the interfaces in its routing table. All right. Now, if your PC1 wants to talk to PC2, which has IP 192.168.1.24, the packet will go to its gateway. Why it will go to its gateway? Because your PC will check its ARP table. How do it check? Just to go to CMD ARP minus A. And it will check the ARP table. It will, and what is the ARP table? ARP table will consist your whatever IP you know along with the MAC address. And it will find, I am not aware how to reach to this different subnet. Let's say that 192.168.8.series or 172.16.8.series, it will not aware these all the subnets. It will only aware the IP which it has assigned, 192.168.1.1 in my PC, my local PC, it has IP. And I only deal with this subnet. If any other subnet I need to ping, what should I do? I will check my routing table, let's say ARP table, and I will see that this subnet is not listed here. Then I will look for my gateway. What is my gateway? 192.168.1.1. And how do I know that? Just put ipconfig and you will come to know what is your gateway. So you can see. You can see here, what's my default gateway here? 192.168.1.1. This is my default gateway. And what is my PCIP? 192.168.1.1. How did I get this? Just mentioning ipconfig over that, the command, okay? And then if I want to access to the different subnet, okay, my IP is 192.168.1.8. I want to reach to 172.16.8.3, which is not belong to my subnet, then my PC will directly send the packet to my gateway. And who is my gateway? Is nothing but router, okay? So as soon as your PC will send the packet to your router will look at its routing table, okay? And its routing table says that, let's say that this is having fast Ethernet 0/0, this is having fast Ethernet 0/1. Your routing table says that 172.16.8.0 subnets connected with this interface. Then it will switch the your packet here, and this guy will again, this is your packet, on the top of that your this interface will add source MAC of its own interface, destination MAC of this PC, and it will send the packet to this PC. So this was the flow, and this is where your router will look for the routing table and then forward the packet to accordingly. This is what we learned in previous class. Any questions so far, guys? All right. Let's say a scenario where you have a internet provider, let's say Airtel or anyone, who comes and give you the leased line connection. And this is your office premises. Your ISP will give one cable connection and you connect that to your router. And let's say this interface is FA0/0. This is your router. We call this in general case, when it is connected to ISP, we call this as a CE router. Customer is router. And the ISP, they must be also having some router in their sides, then only the connection will take place. They are called PE router, provider edge. Clear? So this router, again, other side, let's say that this is FA0/1. It connects to your switch. Okay, Saurav asking, can you say the command to set to connect the different IP or PC? Why the recording? Okay, recording, I think Ram will take care, but yeah, definitely we will, I'll show you the commands, how to configure a router, and you know how to configure your PC. It's just like you can see the corner, there's a network icon, go to network and sharing center. And I hope everyone knows how to assign IP address to your PC. So just go to change adapter settings, and wherever it is Ethernet, just get into Ethernet. In my case, I'm connected to Wi-Fi, but if you connect to wire, you can go with this Ethernet. So in my case, it's unplugged. Just double click on that. If you double click, you will get this kind of wizard. Go for properties, and then you can see something called IP version 4, and just configure it there. Properties, and then you can assign here the static IP, IP subnet mask, default gateway, and then DNS. All right. So that's how you configure your PC. But if you want to configure your router, then let's move to lab session. There I can show it to you. All right. Fine. So this is how. Okay. So let's say that you are having an IP. You connected a router to your switch, and then your all PCs will be connecting to that. Okay. And let's say that you are having 192.168.1. series IP for your LAN subnet, and your internet provider who will not deal with private IP. Guys, hope you are aware what is private IP and what are the public IP ranges. So private IP is nothing but there is a range of IP addresses in each class. Let's say class A, class B, class C, and those are not routable over internet. So if you send any packet with private IP range, your internet will drop the packet. So which kind of IP will travel over the internet? Only the public IP. So public IP will only travel to internet, but not the private IP. And question, why do we require this private IP then if it is not communicating to internet? Why do we require? Because you know that nowadays each smartphone, everyone, each gadgets are having one own IP addresses to communicate. And you have IP version 4 only a certain range. Let's say that you are having 0.0.0.0 till 127.255.255.255 for class A. Then class B, 128 till 191. Class C, 192 till 223. So these ranges are having some limitation. Okay. And one day will come where each device in the world will have one IP addresses, and then there will be no any further IP address left for any new device to assign. Okay. That's the reason this public IP and private IP came into the concept. So what it decided, let's say that in your office network, you have 100 PC. And if this private IP could not be there in existence, what could be happen? You could have given 100 public IP to these PCs. And like that in world, you have so many companies, smaller, bigger, and there are thousand lakhs together the systems there. And some one fine day, you would be coming, oh, I don't have left any of the IP addresses to configure for my new PCs. To come out from this kind of dilemma or this kind of situation, the private IP was introduced. And it was said that you assign all the private IP to your 100 PC because you want all them to communicate within the LAN. You do not want to go to internet because you are connecting to the same PC, same switch. And switch doesn't work on L3. It works purely on L2. So in that case, you can easily communicate to each other. You do not require any public IP, or you do not require to go to internet. But if you want to go to internet, what should you do? You need a public IP. And who will go give this public IP? Your ISP will give the public IP. Your ISP will give, let's say that 193.1.0.0/24. this IP addresses, you will configure to your customized router, your CE router, and you do NATing. There is a very special feature, NAT. This NAT, what will do that? When you send the packet, let's say you want to go to google.com, okay? How the packet looks like, I will just show you that. You will be having, let's say your PC1 wants to go to google.com. Your PC is having 192.168.1.1 IP, and let's say that google.com is having IP 40. Random, I'm taking anything. Okay, so your packet will be constructed like that. Source IP, destination IP, source port, destination port. What is the source IP? Your PC IP 192.168.1.1. What is your destination IP? Google. What is the source port? Anything random. 52,134. By the way, you have port range. Okay, so you can pick up any random IP, random port in this. Doesn't matter. But your source port should be always a defined port. Let's say that port number 80 or port number 443, as applicable. Your application is running on that. Your Google application, okay? So your Google is running on HTTPS is nothing but your port number 443. If it is running HTTP, is nothing but port number 80. Okay? This packet is constructed, and top of that, you make source MAC. Now, this is, you are making frame. You are encapsulating this packet, top of that, and this is called frame. Your source MAC, let's say A.B.C.D. Your destination MAC should be your router gateway. The packet will go to your router. In previous case, we saw that. Now your router, since it is connected to internet, what will do that? It will send all your packets to internet. And that time, since he knows that there is a NAT enabled in it, it will not take this private IP, because it is aware that there is no routing for private IP available. And he will remove this private IP, your source IP, and he will mention a public IP which your provider gave it to you. Let's say that 3. And this he will replace with your private IP. And now it looks like now your source IP will looks like something like that. 193.1.2.3. Where this activity will happen? In router. And what is this activity called? NAT. Network address translation. Okay, now this packet will go to google.com. Google.com will see who is sending this packet to me, this guy. Okay, and what is he looking for? He's looking for the home page of google.com. Okay, let's say somewhere in the internet, your google.com is there. Now, when google.com will reply, then the packet he will interchange. Now, When google.com is replying, who will be the source? This guy will become the source. This IP of the Google will become the source. Why? Because your Google is replying to you. So he is sending the packet to you. So now this will looks like this. Source IP, destination IP, source port, and destination port. Very, very important, guys. If you understand this flow, you can understand networking. 40.1.3.4. And who is the destination IP? 193.1.2.3. What is the source port? Now, this port will become the source port. And what is the destination port? Just reverse. Okay. No packet will come from here to internet. Internet to it will come to your CE router. So CE router now again do the smart job. He will be creating a table in it, which is called translation table. And in that table, he will mention that I got a packet from 192.168.1.1 PC. I removed that IP and I give him this IP. So that when the packet will come back to this router, he will translate back from this IP to this IP. And then the actual packet, which after reaching to router, it looks like that. He will remove this IP, which he netted, and he will mention again back the original IP of your PC, 192.168.1.1. Who will do this activity? Your CE router. And then packet will, he will check in the routing table, this route is available, this subnet is available, and then he will send this packet back to your PC. So this is called NAT process. All right, and this is very, very important, guys. So if because of this, because of private IP addresses, still we are running with IP version 4. Okay, so your IP addresses, it's your IP address is splitted into two portions. One is called version 4, other one is called version 6. Okay. So we are dealing with version 4 at the moment, but few companies started using version 6. What is the difference between both? Version 6 is 128 bit long. It means that it has more IP addresses, which will at least not exhaust in coming future. Let's say that another 30, 40 or 50 years, I don't know, but it will not exhaust at the moment. But why still we are running with IP version 4? With the limited IP addresses because of this NAT, because of this private IP. Please respond back to me if any question, any confusion, or you are clear with that. Then I'll proceed with next point. Guys, no response. Perfect. Okay. Abhishek, IP version 4 and IP version 6 is itself a different topic. It's a lot of mathematics in it. So I think I'm just discussing a fundamental concept. So yeah, when in coming days, when we have the series of all these topics, then definitely you will have the complete knowledge. So Ram will be coming up in coming days with you with the series, or he has some plan where you guys will be having a complete in-depth knowledge on that. So at the moment, I would be only giving you the concept. All right, thanks. Then next is, let's say that I have a cloud ISP, and in my company, let's say that my CE router, I connected with that. Okay, and this is a switch, and there is an intruder. Do you know intruder? Who is an uninvited guy? He's an attacker, and he wants to reach. Let's say that, and you connected a server here in your company. Let's say that it's a web server. You have, let's say, database server. And this intruder, this will be keep pinging your public IP, because this public IP, which your ISP will give, it is reachable in cloud anywhere. Okay. Then he'll be keep pinging your router. Even he can, if you have any NAT or something, or let's say that if any public IP you configured, of your any server, it can keep attacking, keep reaching, keep continuous pinging. When it will be keep continuous pinging, your router by default will be replying to all the requests. And this will way, this router will be not available or he'll be full exhausted so that he cannot attend the genuine traffic. If let's say that I'm the genuine guy from the internet, I want to access my web server and this router is full exhausted. His CPU memory is completely exhausted with replying this guy. Because there are many intruders who will be keep attacking to you purposely. This is called DDoS attack. Okay? He will make your resource unavailable so that your genuine request cannot be handled by the router. So as a security guy, what is your job? To check the logs. Logs of this router, find it out. There is a someone intruder who will be keep attacking to you, to your router. And then you would like, or your management says, please block this guy. He is keep attacking and making DDoS kind of attack. Please block him so that it should not come to my router and get, my router should not respond back to this guy. And then there is a particular service called ACL. Access control list. This will help to block whoever you want and whichever direction you want. If it is from internet to inside, or let's say that from inside to outside, any guys who is creating the problem, even you can block that. But here you need to do this manually. All right, your router will not do by default. C stands for customer edge. Okay. So this ACL will block this guy. Okay. So Ankit, it's something like that. DDoS, just try in that way. Like I continuously ping from multiple of the places to your public IP of your router or firewalls. And it will be keep busy in replying. And then it will, if each reply, he has to construct the packet, right? And he has to send to outside. This will be consuming some of your process, of your, let's say CPU, your memory, some portion, some moment will come where it will be keep exhausted replying to this kind of request. And someone genuine guy who wants to access your web server or database server from outside, probably he has to wait till their CPU and memory gets free. And this kind of attack we call this DDoS attack. There are many such attacks. There are called, let's say that half TCP attack. Let's say that there is a SYN attack, SYN attack. So many attacks. When you discuss this with network security or cyber security, you will come with this kind of attacks. Okay, signature attack. Yeah, many such. Okay, so when you I think I lost my diagram. So let me go to the fresh new page. Yeah. So what I was mentioning is, my CE router and this intruder, he is attacking to me. Let's say that 20.10.1.4. This is one of the public IP. And from this, he is attacking to your CE router. And your management wants this to be blocked, this IP. So there is an ACL which you need to create. And that ACL, how do you create? So in the router, there are two ways to create the ACL. Actually, there are three ways. One is called standard. Extended. And there is an advanced version of this called IP-based or let's say that naming ACL, name-based ACL, not IPUs, name-based ACL, sorry. What are the difference of these three? Quickly, because these three are very, very important if I want to teach firewall. Ram, I think I'm allowed to go till 4:30. Ram, okay. Guys, should we go till 1.5 hours if you guys are available, or I can then accordingly I'll plan what speed should I proceed on this? Yes, no. Okay. So no answer means always positive answer. Yeah, thanks, Dheeraj. Okay, so Ankit says no. Okay, fine. So 4 o'clock, I think we can go with that. So let's go with standard ACL and extended ACL difference. What is difference between standard ACL and extended ACL? Let's say that this guy, he wants to keep continuous ping to me. What I'll do that, I'll block this completely. What do you mean by completely? Means any port, whether it's ICMP, whether it's TCP, whether it's UDP, any port, if this guy wants to reach to me, directly his packet will be dropped. He's completely blocked to come to my house. And that I can do with standard ACL. Complete close the door for him. Okay? But extended ACL means I have some mercy on this guy. Let's say that I will block his ping. Ping use ICMP protocol. I block this protocol so that he cannot ping to me, but I will allow his TCP packets, because who knows, he wants to access my web server, which is in my premises. I'm hosting some websites of my company, let's say Amazon or anything, which he wants to access. On that person, I cannot block him because it will look rude. Then I will go with extended ACL. So it's very clear that extended ACL, you can block on the protocol wise. Whether it's a TCP, whether it's ICMP or mini such. Okay. And on the port wise as well. But if you want completely to lock down this guy to enter to your house, you need to go to standard ACL. There is a problem, and that problem I will not explain to you in theory, but I'll explain to you in the practical wise. And let's move to our practical lab. Okay, so there was some lab, it was ready. So I need to change. I have a router here. Let's say that your cloud is nothing but again, there is a ISP side router. And let's say I have a switch. Okay. And I have a PC here. Let's do quickly connectivity of this. So now this looks like more realistic. So I have, let's say ISP here, or let's say internet. We generally refer this as a cloud. And then I have a C router here. I give this name as a P1. Okay, it's not changing, so that's fine to me. And then I want to see which all the ports I'm connected with. Okay. Let's go quickly, start them. I want to start everyone, okay? And then let's say that I have intruder here. So my intruder is connected to internet. Okay, so let's start. I quickly configure here my LAN subnet. Let's say 192.168.1.0/24. And okay, so this can be on this LAN side. And then I configure, let's say this intruder is having IP 20.1.1.2, and I have between my internet provider has given me IP, let's say that 193.1.1.0/24. In that case, I will give .1 IP to R1, and in this series .2 IP to internet. Okay, let's start everyone. Okay, and then I just proceed to configure R1. Let me know if you can see it. If the font is clear, or should I enlarge that of this CLI? Okay. So it's ready. How do we, you see all the interfaces of the router? The command is show IP interface brief. This will give you all the interface connected to that. Okay, so you have three interfaces here, and which interface connected to internet? F1/0, this is. Okay, F is nothing but fast Ethernet. Let me get into this quickly. How do you configure interface? And which interface should I configure? 1/0, which is connected to internet. Okay, first task, let me bring it up, no cert. Why do I put this command? Because by default, all interfaces in your router will be administratively down. So you need to do no cert, which will bring this interface up. Okay, and you can see now, the message has come that this interface is up. Now I want to give IP address. What should be the IP address? My ISP, which provided the IP 1.1.1. And what is the subnet mask? 255.255.255.0. Why? Because /24. Okay, I have one more interface in this. What is that? F0/0. And where it is connected? To my LAN. Okay, no cert. And what should be the IP address of my LAN? My LAN IP address is 192.168.1.1. Okay, I think I have done no cert already. So let me again verify. So IP interface brief is the command. Can you see this? 0/0 is having 192.168.1.1, which is the plan of my network. And FA1/0 is having ISP provided IP, and both are up. Good. So now I can check my routing table. What did I mention in the previous moments? Like, if you configure any interface, any IP address, by default your routing table will create. And what is the command? So IP route. This will tell you all your routing tables. C means connected. Can you see, its definition is here. C means connected. And what are the subnets connected? 192.193.1.1.0 and 192.168.1.0. Okay. Yeah. Now it's ready. Now I go back to my PC1 and I'll configure the same range of IP to it. IP 192.168.1.2. 255.255.255.0. And what should be my gateway? 192.168.1.1. This is the router router interface IP, FA0/0. Can I ping my gateway? Yes, I can ping. So if your gateway is pinging, you can access all your internet related stuff. If your gateway is not pinging, you cannot access any internet related stuff. Okay, so this is the basic troubleshooting. Whenever anybody complains, my internet is not working, what do you do? First ping your gateway. If your gateway is pinging, then still your internet is not working, then what could be the issue? Your, this line, the ISP line between your C router to ISP looks down. And how do you verify this in more accurate way? You need to log into R1. Okay, let's go back to internet router. That is, in my case, PE router, and I'm going to configure it. Let me change host name CE router so that it is very clear to you guys that I am dealing with C router. And here in internet, it's obviously the name is itself correct, internet. So check the interface. I have two interfaces connected on the internet router, which is FA0/0, which is connected to my C router. So let me configure this quickly. Okay, what is the command? Let me first put NoSet. What is the command? So address, IP address and 193.1.1. I'll give 2 IP to this. Okay, come back, go to next interface. FA1/0, no set, IP address, 20.1.1.1, 255.255.255.0, and that's all. Check out. So IP interface brief will give you the list. Why did I give 20.1.1.1? Because PC2, this guy is connected with this range. So I picked up first IP for router and the second IP to my intruder. Okay, this is how everywhere it works. Now you have the routing table with you. Check it out. So IP route. You have routing table with you. All right. Can you ping from internet to your CE router? Check it out. 193.1.1.1 is the C router IP. I can ping. This explanatory mark says I can ping it. So my scenario where I said that my LAN users are unable to access internet, but I can ping my gateway, it means that I can reach till FA0/0, but looks like this line would be down. How do you verify? Get log into your C router and in your internet router, which is your gateway, and I'm able to ping. So if I'm able to ping, means there is no problem till my local provider. And then you call local provider, he will tell you if there is any problem he has further. So this is how you will troubleshoot one by one hops. Clear? Yes, no? Any questions so far, guys? Then I'll proceed to ACL. So no response is always positive response. Okay. Yes, sir. Little bit clear. Okay. So Prabhujot, what's the question? Where it's not clear? So it's a very clear stuff. Guys, PC1 wants to talk to, let's say that internet, he will send the packet to gateway, which is IP of FA0/0. and it should be the IP 192.168.1.1. If the packet reached to R1, R1 will check its routing table whether the destination is available in the routing table or not. If not available, he will drop the packet. If it is available, he will forward this packet to the destination. So it's a simple process, okay? If somebody asks you how to go to, let's say, UK, and you're not aware, you say, I don't know, you'll drop the packet. But if you know, you'll tell, please go to international airport. From there, you catch the flight, this flight, and you can go there. So you are the router. And if you are not knowing, you're not knowing, you drop the packet. This is what exactly router does. Okay. Yeah. So now, before coming to ACL, very important stuff I missed, which is routing, or how to do routing. So if your router is not aware how to reach to the destination, you will tell him that please go this way. So let's say that your internet ISP provider connected to your C router, connected to your switch, your PC is connected here. Okay, and let's say its name is R1, here internet, and here you have google.com. Your C router, send your PC wants to access google.com, he will send the packet to gateway. Your C router is not aware how to go to google.com, so you will configure a static, or it's a, say that default route, which will tell that anybody coming for any destination, blindly you send the packet to internet or your ISP P router. Your P router headache is to take care further how to route this to Google. Okay. Example, if you go to ask any information to any hospital, they will redirect you to help desk. Please go and ask to help desk. They will be knowing which doctor, which department you need to deal with. They will not take that headache. They will all redirect you to help desk of that place. Or any company, if you go, they will redirect you to reception. So here, you are telling your R1 that any traffic, anybody is asking how to reach to google.com, send them to your internet provider. Don't take headache. And that is called default route. Default route. So how do you tell, how do you configure default route in your C router? Very simple. Go to IP, route, and any destination always resemble with this 0000. And any subject mask, again 0.0.0.0. And anybody with any subject mask coming to you, you send back to where? Your P router IP address. In my case, it was 193.1.1.2. So what I'm telling my C router, that any packet coming to you looking for any destination, whether it's google.com, reddit.com, Hotmail, Facebook, anywhere, blindly you send all those packets to your C router, means this guy. Sorry, P router, your internet. Okay, let's do that. How to do this? Go to lab, and I am going to tell, okay, so my PC wants to reach 20.1.1.2. So what will do that? Let's ping and see whether it can reach to that or not. 20.2.1.1.2 is the, and you can see who is replying you back. Your gateway is replying you back. And what is replying? Destination host unreachable. I don't know. I don't know where this destination is located. Who is telling this? Your C router. So it's my duty to tell my C router, please forward all your packets to internet so that internet will take care that part. Okay, get into this. I'm into my C router, and how do I configure? IP route, and what I'm going to do, default route. Default route means any destination IP with any subnet mask please send them back to your internet. And what is internet IP? 193.1.1.2. Okay. Sorry, it's 2.0 is mentioned here. Now check your routing table. So IP route. And as soon as you see, it's mentioned here S. What is meant by S? Static. Means I configured it manually. And why there is a asterisk mark here? Why? Because it's the default route. Okay. So I have configured my default route pointing to my P router, my internet router. And question, how do you get this P router IP address? Your ISP will give it to you when you take the internet connection. Okay. Now come back to PC. Again, ping it. Now you see the response. Response is now different coming. What is coming? Timeout. Why timeout? Why it's not destination host unreachable? Because now your packet coming from here, PC to your router R1, and your router is known that I need to send all the traffic to where? This internet router. So your traffic will reach to internet router. But when internet router, again, he will see what is the destination you are pinging? 20.1.1.2. And he will ask, he will check his routing table, whether I'm knowing this. Yes, he is knowing because it is directly connected subnet. So he knows 20.1.1.2 where it is located. So he will forward your packet from 0/0 to 1/0, this interface. From there, the packet will come here. But now this guy has to reply back. Who has to reply? This PC2 has to reply back to you. He has received your letter. Now he has to write back to you the letter, right? So when he will reply back, what will be the source? 20.1.1.2. What will be the destination? 192.168.1.2, the PC1 IP address. Any question till now here? Have you understood till halfway communications? Your PC1 packet reaching to PC2. Any confusion till now here? You want me to explain again? It's clear. Thanks, Prabhujot. Anyone else? Any question or any confusion, or should I proceed next? Guys, please be responsive. Okay, so, okay, now let's say, so PC2 has received the packet. Now he has to reply back to PC1. And now how the packet flow will happen? I'll go back to my note. And I will explain to you here. So now your PC2, which is connected to your internet, and your internet is connected to your CE router. CE router is connected to your PC1. Your PC1 is having IP 192.168.1.2, and your PC2 is having IP 20.1.1.2. And this is having gateway 20.1.1.1. This is having gateway 192.168.1.1. When PC2 will reply back to PC1, packet will look like that. Source IP 20.1.1.2. Destination IP 192.168.1.2. Source port. Anything random, or let's say that since it is Google, or let's say some something 80, port number 80, I'll take it. What is the destination port? 52,134. This will be the dynamic port. Source will be from the requester, always it will be the dynamic ports. Now this packet will go to the gateway of this PC2. PC2 will send the packet to the gateway, which is in this case his local internet. His local internet will look whether I am aware of this 192.168.1.subnet or not. In my case, check it out, his routing table. Is internet aware about 192.168.1.1. No, he's not aware. Check it out. He's not having any entry in this. And that's the reason your internet is dropping the packet. Now, we need to tell to this internet router that how can he reach this particular subnet. For that, again, I need to do a route. Command IP route, which destination he wants to reach? 192.168.1.0. And what it is the subnet mask it has? 255.255.255.0. And how to reach to this subnet? He need to send the packet to my C router FA1/0 interface IP. And what is that IP? 193.1.1.1. Check it out, your routing table now. Now this guy is aware how to reach to this subnet, and he need to send that packet to this particular IP address. Means in my case, this is my C router. Okay, so now I have told. Now I have told my internet provider that to reach out to this particular subnet, please send your packet to this particular IP address 193.1.1.1. Now, TC2, when replying back, the packet has gone to internet router. Internet router will look at its routing table. Whether do I know this, how to reach to this particular subnet, 192.168.1.2? Yes, I added one static route here. And I told that if you want to reach to this particular destination, send your packet to this particular IP, 193.1.1.1. As soon as packet will reach to my C router, what my C router will do? He will again check its routing table, and he is aware where this particular subnet is located, and easily he will send the packet to this guy. Okay. Come back to my lab. So I have added this static route. Now come to PC1 and again ping this IP. Why I am getting this? Request timeout. Okay. I am getting request timeout. But I need to find it out why. So I have created my C router saying that all my packets to go to this particular IP. Can I reach to this IP? Yes. Okay. And I have 192.1.193.1.1.1 IP. Now I'll go to C internet router. And I will check here 192.168.1.0 is reachable to me. Okay. By this particular destination. Can I ping this destination? Yes, I can ping. But guys, I have not configured my PC2. Do you remember? I have never touched this. I need to give IP address to this, right? So let's do that. IP 20.1.1.2.255.255.255.0. And what should be the gateway? We forgot to give IP address to PC2. Now you ping, and it should be 100% ping. Check it out. Okay. So now from PC1, which has IP 192.168.1.2, I can ping 20.1.1.2, and which is the IP of your PC2. Okay. So this is called routing. This is how your routing happens. So what we learn? We learn static route. This is called default route and static route. We learn together here. Okay. So let's note it out here. If I want to create default route, command is IP route 0.0.0.0. And next hop IP. Okay. And if you want to create a static route, IP route, let's say that any destination IP, in my example, it's 192.168.1.0. That can be anything. And next hop IP address. What do you mean by next hop? Next hop is nothing but your next available IP address. So for my C router, What is my next hop? Internet. And for internet, what is next hop? My C router. Here. So this is what it's all about, IP routing. Now you come back to ACL, and then we'll move to firewalling. Okay. So as I mentioned, this 20.1.1.2, this is an intruder, and he wants to continuously ping my IP of R1, my C router, 193.1.1.1. He's continuously pinging that. Okay, his job is to keep engaging me from replying. Okay, continuously he's pinging me. So I want to block this guy to ping me. How do I do? I will create an access list. So for creating that access list, I will get into my C router and the command is for creating this access list is access list. Use always the question mark if you forgot what to use the next command. So if you see here, there is a number one from 1 till 99. This is called standard access list. So if you use any number from 1 to 99, your router will automatically understand you are going to use standard access list. So in my case, I will use 10. 10 belongs to this range, 1 to 99. It means that I'm using standard access list. Question mark. What do I want to do with this packet? I want to deny. I don't want him to come to me. And whom I want to deny? I want to deny host 20.1.1.2. So I have created the rule, but I need to apply this somewhere. Where should I apply this? To FA1/0 interface. This interface, which is connected to internet, because this guy is coming via internet to me, right? So I need to block here. Which direction? He is coming out to in, right? Means he is coming in direction. His packet is coming into me, right? So there is a direction, guys. In access list, always there is a direction. So if one access list, you can apply either in incoming direction or outgoing direction of one interface. Okay. So I have created access list, means rule I have created. I want to apply. Where should I apply? F1/0. What is the command? IP access. And here it will not be called access list. Here it will be called as access group. In this group, which access list, which rule I want to call? Rule number 10. So I'll mention the rule name. And which direction? The packet is coming from internet to inside to me. So I'll mention in direction. All right, let's do. What is your saying? Communication administratively prohibited. What was the earlier? It was replying back to you. Now it is dropping your packet and sending you the message. This is the beauty of your ICMP, guys. If your ICMP is blocking for any reason, it will always notify to you that why I am doing this. Okay. So if it is destination host unreachable, it means there is a routing issue. If there is a such kind of message which is prohibiting your packets, it means there is an ACL. Clear to me? So this is how I will block any attack on my edge router. Very important point for security reason. Clear to you guys? ACL, NAT, and routing. If yes, then I'll proceed for firewall configuration. Okay. Yeah. Now, here is the difference. When you used C router as your router, your router is a very dumb guy. He's not blocking anything. He let everything pass through it. But if you use your firewall is by heart, it is router, but with security feature. Okay, so what is the difference between router and firewall? Your firewall is also essentially a router, but with added security feature in it. Okay, so if you use your firewall here, your firewall will by default block all the packet which is coming from internet to it. So if this intruder, he wants to reach, and if you use here the firewall, let's change this to firewall. I use a firewall here, and let me connect it. Okay. So which firewall I'm using here? I'm using Cisco ASA firewall. What version? 9.8.1. Okay. So in this, when I use the firewall, by default, your router, let's say that your internet, any traffic is coming to this firewall, and this firewall is located to your office environment. Is in this case, it's acting as a C device, customer edge equipment. Okay, your by default your external, your internet traffic by default, it will be dropped on the in the firewall. Okay, you don't need to do anything specifically. And if you want anyone to allow from outside to inside, then you need to kick the hole in the wall of your firewall. Firewall means what? It's creating a wall from outside. Anybody cannot come in. But if you want any one person to come in, you need to put one hole in the wall so that that guy can come via that. And how will you do this? With help of ACL. Okay, so let's quickly move some theory, guys, for firewall before moving to, because if you do not understand the theory, then it's difficult to configure firewall. Firewall connected to my internet. And let's say that I mention is FW and then a PC. Whenever any firewall, okay, it has by default split into two zone. Okay, two zone means two kind of boundary. One is called untrusted, and one is called trusted. Example, in your family, you trust everyone, your mother, your father, everyone you trust. But if anybody outside say something, you do not trust to that guy. Same matter here. If anybody from internet, he is coming and knocking the door, you will not trust on that guy and you will kick him off. You will block his access. This is called untrusted. The guy is untrusted. The data, the traffic is coming to me is untrusted. But in your LAN, which is your network, anybody is going out, you will open the door and let him go out. Means you are trusting on that traffic. Here, now this trusted and untrusted, we bind. How do you configure? How do you tell your firewall that which interface is trusted, which interface is untrusted? With the help of security label. So if this interface which is connected to LAN, you mention the security label 100. Means your security label range is 0 to 100. So if any one interface you want to trust, assign them the highest security level number. And anybody which is not trusted, you assign them security label 0. Okay. So if you mention this interface with security level 100 and this interface is connected to your LAN, it means they are trusted guys. And this interface, which is connected to internet, if you configure the, you assign the security label 0, it means this guy is untrusted guy. What is the command to do that? It's a very simple. Let's say that this is E0/0 interface, or let's say that it's this is E0/1 interface. So you need to get into E0/0, which is your untrusted. You have decided that this guy will be connected to internet and it should be untrusted. So you give the name to this. And what is the command? Name if. Name if is name interface. What name you want to give to this interface? Outside. He is the guy who is going to connect to outside people. As soon as you mention this keyword outside, by default, it is binded with security label 0. Okay. And now you come to this interface E0/1, which is connected to your LAN. And this guy, you decided that this should be very, very trusted. What you will give the name? Name if inside. Why? Because he's connecting to your inside network. As soon as you give this name, this inside name to this interface, by default, he is binded with security level 100. So see, so many automations there in that. You just give the name outside, it will automatically map with security level 0. Here, if you give inside, automatically it will map with security level 100. Okay? And as soon as you do this activity, it is automatically create a rule that anybody coming from inside going to outside, I will allow them to go. But if and somebody is coming from outside to inside, I will kick them. I will not allow them. Okay, go back to our lab. Yeah, coming to that point, Ganpati. Okay, good that I have intelligent audience. They are putting very good questions. I'm just coming to that. So let's configure ASA. So when you see this greater mark, what is mean by that? You are in the user privilege mode. From here to you need to get into from user mode, you need to get into privilege mode. And how do you do this? You guys have seen in the routers and all. Just type in. In means enable. And enter. Can anyone of you tell me what could be the password of a brand new firewall when you connect first time? Anyone of you? No. So there is no any enable mode password into ASA firewall. There is no, it's blank. Now question is there, why then I'm keeping here the prompt, password prompt, if there is a blank password, there is nothing password exist. To test your knowledge, whether you are the genuine guy, you know the firewall configuration, or you are just simply playing with that device. Just put enter button and you are into privilege mode. So it's blank password, Ganpati. Okay, now I want to check how many interface it has, like in the router, what command we used? So IP interface brief. In the firewall, this command doesn't work. You need to shuffle, so interface IP brief. Just shuffle IP and just flip IP and interface to each other. And then you'll get so interface IP brief. Check it out here. If you type so IP interface brief, what will happen? You will get the error. Okay, so this command only work for switch and router, not in the firewall. In the firewall, what will do? So interface IP brief. All right. And when you do this, you will come to know how many interfaces I have. So in my case, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 interface, but it depends model to model. Okay. So I have this much interface. Now my G0/0 is connecting to LAN. So let me first configure it. Interface G0/0. Okay. First command, as we did in the router, I'll do here NoSUC, because by default it is administratively down. You see this? By default, they're administratively down. So we need to bring it up by putting NoSUC command. Then I want to mention IP address. What should be the IP address for me? My LAN IP is 192.168.1.0, and in this I'll give 1.1 IP to my firewall. Okay. Another beauty of this firewall is in the router, you used to mention the subnet mask 255.255.255.0, but your router will check whether this is class A, class B, class C IP. So since it is belong to class C, by default your class C subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. So if you put put enter here, it will accept, and it will in your behalf it will add subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Okay, there is no harm mentioning this if you want. Okay, there is no harm, you can do this, but I want you to show this automatically. Your firewall will take this. So I have given the IP address. Now I need to assign name to this interface. What should I give the name? Where it is connected? In my inside network, in my LAN network. So the name should be inside. Question, inside is case sensitive or not? It is not case sensitive. You can put caps, you can put a smaller case, doesn't matter. As soon as you put enter, what did you say? Information, my inside security label is 100 by default. It means your inside keyword is mapped with your security label 100, and your router, your firewall will always look at security label. If it is 100, this guy is most trusted guy. Let him go out. Don't inspect him. Don't check to him. All right. Come back to next. Which interface? G0/0. I'm sorry, I configured wrongly. 0/0 is connected to internet, and I configured here wrongly. So let me quickly go back and remove the IP address. Command is just put no. Any command if you want to remove, just put no before that. What should be the internet based IP? 193.1.1.1, 255.255.255.0, and then name if. What is the 0/0 connected with? It's connected to internet. So I should be mentioning here outside name. And as soon as I put outside, you can see it is mapped with security level 0. Clear? Come back to quickly your LAN, which is 0/1. Put no sir. Give IP 192.168.1.1, 255.255.255.0. If you want, you can mention this subnet. If you don't want, you just put it enter. It will automatically take the default one. Sorry, it should be address here. Okay, and then name if. As soon as you mention this, it will come as a security level 100. Now answer to Prabhujot, how to mention, how to configure the security level. The simple things, just go to, let's say I want to change the security level. Command is security level and put the question mark. Whatever the number you want to mention, you can mention it here. All right. So now I have configured my firewall. Check it out. So interface IP brief, and you can check it has taken two IP address. Okay, 0/0 is having 193.1.1.1. It is connected to internet, and 0/1 is having 192.168.1.1. Now let's go to testing. Now PC1 wants to ping 193.1.1.2, which is your internet router IP. Can it ping or not? Check it out. Go to PC1. Okay. It's something, I think we need to start it. So IP, and I need to reconfigure IP because I set no set everything. And gateway 192.168.1.1. Right. Go back to next device, which is my internet, and configure it again. So if you see my internet router, what configuration should I put? I need to go into FA0/0, which is connected to my C router, and I'll give the same range of IP address, 193.1.1.2, 255.255.255.0, more set. Then get it to another interface, which is FA1/0. 20.1.1.1 and 255.255.255.0. No, sir. That's all. Check your routing table. So your routing table is having now both IP address. Now go back to PC2 and configure the IP 20.1.1.2. Check your PC can ping its gateway. Yes, it should be. No, yeah, it's pinging. Can your PC1 ping its gateway? Yes, it can ping. So now my topology is ready. Now I want to ping PC1 to internet router 193.1.1.2. Can I ping it? Can anybody tell me whether I can ping or not? Professor Ganpati, anyone? From PC1, can I ping my internet P router IP? Let's do 193.1.1.2. This is the IP of my P router. I'm getting request timeout. Why I'm getting request timeout? Can anyone tell me? Why I'm getting request timeout? Because my packet from PC1, it's reaching to firewall. But my firewall is not aware. My firewall, since it is having a routing table in it, which is knowing that where this guy 193.1.1.0 is available, he is connected to outside interface. The packet will go to internet. But when internet router wants to reply back to 192.168.1.0, he is not aware where this guy is. How? Because it is not there in his routing table. Okay. So your router first, I need to tell where this 192.168.0.0 available. Let me add a route. And to reach out to this subnet, the packet should go to my firewall. I'm telling to router, sorry, internet router, that if you want to reach to this subnet, send your packet to my C firewall. Okay. And what is the IP of that? All right. Look at the routing table now. Now my internet router is aware how to reach to my inside network. Okay, practically there is private IP is not routable over the internet, but for lab purpose it's fine. Okay, now go to PC1 and try to ping. I'm getting request timeout. Why? Because my firewall is a very, very secured guy. Okay. He will tell that I'm sending your packet to internet. But when internet is replying back to me, I have very strong instructions that I will not allow anyone from untrusted to trusted zone. If you want this guy to allow, please create a hole in this wall. Kick the hole in this wall. And how? With the help of ACL. Okay? So how do you create ACL? In the firewall. Go to your firewall and type access list. Okay. In this firewall, there is no any standard or extended access list. There is only name based access list. So you need to give some name to this access list. I'll give anything. ABC, EFG, anything. Sandeep, Ram, any name you can give as you like. Okay. Next, what do you want to do? I want to permit. Which protocol? ICMP, because I'm dealing with ping. Okay, and who is the guy whom you want to permit? The guy is, let's say, in my case, 193.1.1.2. Okay, I want to permit this guy to where? I want to permit to anywhere in my inside network. Anyone, any PC of my LAN can ping this guy. Okay. Enter. So I have created a rule in my firewall saying that ICMP protocol you permit if the source 193.1.1.2 wants to come back to any PC of my internal LAN. So when I'm sending this packet to this guy and this guy will reply back, now he will become the source. And he should be allowed here to come in. And that's where I created the rule. But I have created rule, but I have not applied it anywhere. How to apply? Go to access group. Okay. What is the name of your rule? ABC. Which direction? In direction I want to allow, right? Because from outside somebody is coming to in. Okay. Which interface? Interface is, I have only two interfaces, outside and inside. So I'll create outside. Check it out now. It should work or not? It's working. Okay. So this is the case of your ICMP. Ping. Ping is always behaving a different way. When you send the packet from source to destination, destination will reconstruct the packet where he will become the source, and the guy who requested for ping will become the destination and reply back. When this changes will happen, your firewall will treat this as a new packet. And then you need this kind of access list. But there is another way, okay? This is a part of ICMP because it's required because of this DDoS attack or many kind of manipulations. But if you want to access google.com, yahoo.com, and those reply coming, these are called TCP IP communications. When you're requesting google.com, means you are generating a TCP packet. So any packet which is with TCP and UDP protocol, they will pass through this firewall. Firewall will immediately make note of this. PC1 guy has gone out searching of google.com. So if google.com is replying back to PC1, I should allow him. Okay. So this kind of entry he will make in it. And we call this entry as state connection, state table or connection table. The answer to, I think someone asked this question. So your firewall is a security guard of your apartment, if you buy a new apartment, you're going out for your office, you will sign the register, you go out. But when you come back, this guy may not recognize you because you are the new guy. He will check the register. He will say that you already have the entry and he will let you come in. Exactly, this is what done by your state connection, state table or connection table. Okay, let me show it to you. So I'll go to internet router and I will enable telnet. How do I enable? Line VTY04, you need to get into this line, type password. Let me put Cisco or anything password you want to put and type login. Okay. Now go to PC1. I don't know if this will support or not telnet, but I'll try. 193.1.1.2. Sorry, it's not supporting telnet. So I need to keep another something here, some router in this place. So if I keep any router here, it will probably work. So let me quickly configure one router here. But in real case, your PC always support telnet, but this is the simulation. So they have not given this capability to this PC to telnet. All right. So I'm just started. I'm getting into the console of this and I'll quickly configure this. What's the port? FA0/0. Okay. So I'll go to R1. I'll configure FA0/0. What should be the IP? Since I have 192.168.1. series IP, I'll give 3. Because 1 and 2 already I have used. Okay, I'm sorry, I have to mention your IP address. No sir. And a default route pointing to my gateway. So any traffic I'll send to my gateway. And this should be 192.168.1.com. Okay, so my R1 is ready. Now let me check my reachability. 193.1.1.2. That is my P router IP. I can ping. Now let me telnet. 193.1.1.2. Check it out. It's asking the password. Whose password? P router password. And what password do I mention? Cisco. And where I am now? Internet router. Okay. Now I was mentioning to you the state table or connection table. Let me check it out. The command is so. I think it would not be supporting this particular command. Sorry. Check it out. It's supporting here. So socon. Socon is nothing but listing your connection table. Guys, give me 1 minute time. And I have one guest here, so I'll just come back. Just give me 5 minutes.
Guys, in the meanwhile, please fill up a Google form that we have shared. Actually, that will help us to send your recording very soon.
Okay, guys, I'm back. So, connection, CONN, that command will tell you your table, your connection table. And in this connection table, you can see that this guy wanted to come back and his source port is 23. And he wanted to come back to 192.168.1.3, which is my internal router, which I just configured, and please allow this guy. Okay, so based on this connection table, your firewall will allow this connection. Here, so this is for today till now, and I think this is the fundamental of your firewall, how you configure your firewall, make it ports configured, make your ACL configured, and yeah, that's all so far. So any question, guys, you can put back for 10 minutes, we'll keep for question and then we'll wind up the call. No question? Ram?
Yes. Please put up your questions on chat box so that we can take it up.
So I think this class become a little lengthy.
I think everybody is still absorbing whatever we have discussed. So guys, don't worry. We'll share the videos with you. Go through it in your own time. I think this is some of them maybe very, very new concept for you. Probably Sandeep will be with us for a few more sessions also in future. We'll share you whenever there's going to be schedule for him. Maybe you can keep your questions ready for them. So in case if you don't have any questions, we will close the session now. Thanks a lot, Sandeep, for giving us the time. It was a very, very detailed and very, very in-depth session. I think people who have stayed till the end, they must have been really, really appreciating it. And we got very good response also from the cohort. Thanks a lot, guys. And please, everyone, do check out our Antwork website. We have shared also a link where you can find out about our program. Few of new programs are coming up exactly for you guys, people who are starting their career. Very awesome cohort we are building up, that's it. I hope everybody used this session very well. Sandeep can just tell you also whatever we have taught you. Sandeep, I think you can tell Sandeep. I think this is a part of also some of the certifications, right?
Yes. So this is the part of CCI security, CCNA, CCNP security. So when you start your career, you want to go through CCNA security certification. This is very, very essential topics. And when you write the exam, you will be having all the questions based on this. So it's very simple. You have a very good understanding of the flow of the packet, where it can block. You start checking each hop wise, and then you understand the flow, then you can answer all the questions.
Mahira, you have raised your hand. Do you have any question? Okay, no. Guys, keep a lookout at our Antwork website also. We'll keep on informing you about the new sessions which are coming up, right? And enjoy your weekend. Thanks a lot, Sandeep, again.
Thank you. Thanks, Ram. Thank you, guys, for listening. Bye-bye.
Yeah.